I have looked at some various insect trapping devices recently, but this one's different because it's designed to sit in the floor and attract floor-dwelling bugs like fleas and things like that. And it says, four lights attractant, easy and convenient to protect your healthy. Oh, so close, just one letter off. Multifunctional pest catcher. And if we look at the instructions, it says, well, let's focus down onto this. Let's zoom in fact. Let's let you read along. Notes. One, level 1 to 2 warm light can be used for moth, flea, and mite. Level 3 and 4 UV light can be used for mosquito and fly. Or three, turn off the light can be used for cockroaches. Oh, missing A. Ant and bed bug. This item can work with 5-volt 1 amp adapter, power bank, etc. We shall test that. So let's zoom back out and we'll unbox it. Let's have a little unboxing moment. Like unbox therapy, but less expensive. I'll give you a link to this. It came from AliExpress. Everything's coming from AliExpress these days. I like the fact that if I provide a link to their site, they don't gouge the price like eBay does. And the stuff's cheaper than eBay. So there you go. Put the sticker on the bottom, put attractant on the dicer. Oh, sticker. Put attractant in the sticker. It didn't mention anything about that. Plug the item in. Don't cover the light. You can change different light for different bugs. Okay, right. So here is the unit. It's very stylish. You can open it by bayonet capping the top off like this. And inside are a power supply cable and these discs, which I shall attempt to bang out. So, how many discs do you get? I didn't know you got discs, so I bought other ones. You get one, hold on, one, two, three, four. Just, oh no, there's another one there. Five. You get five discs as far as I can see. And these are the ones that are the sticky discs. You've got the little bit you can peel up here. And when you peel it up, that is a sticky surface designed to trap the bugs. What attracts them though is this light. Good lord, that's a lot of circuitry. Wow. Okay. I did buy more discs. These are the discs it uses. These are the discs I got. They're designed for a completely different trap. Lots of useless round discs. Well, let me give you the measurements then. Hold on. Here is a measuring tape. It's a British measuring tape and therefore in metric and imperial. It's 135 millimeters and 5 1/4 inches roughly across with a hole in the middle. Approximately, well, let's use the calipers for that. Let's use the calipers to measure the hole. It's about 15 millimeters diameter. Right, excellent. So let me show you what happens when this is plugged in. Where's the lead? Where's the lead? I will plug it into a power bank and a little power meter, and then of course I shall whip the circuit board out and we'll take a look at it. So here is the lead you get. It's a decent lead. It's exactly 1 meter long. I will get the power bank and plug this in. Plug this cable into the power bank. There we go. And we'll plug it in and see what this does. It's USB-C. Initial power consumption, 76 milliamps? Doing nothing? What's that doing? We shall find out. I shall reverse engineer it. But 76 milliamps standby, it doesn't matter. It's designed really to be plugged into a wall socket. So there's the white, and it's 132 milliamps. Let's zoom down this so you can actually see this. Let's focus on that so you can see the results here. So that's 132 milliamps. What's the next mode? It's dim white, which is 100 milliamps. And then we've got a deep violet, 136 milliamps. That looks quite deep, actually. That may be. I wonder what that is. It's visible. That doesn't always mean anything. And the lower setting, that 100 milliamps, and then off and just 76 milliamps again. Why is there such a high standby current? What is this doing? It's worth mentioning that these are based on a flea trap that is still available that takes a 15-watt light bulb. And the 15-watt light bulb inside just runs off the mains. You can still buy that type. And it was supposed to be the heat and the light attracted fleas. There was another version that turned on and off, and it was supposed to be that when the fleas detected something going in front of the source of light, they'd jump as if there was some animal there to jump onto. I'm not sure how true that is. Don't know the techniques that fleas use to propagate. But I got one for my mum and dad because ages ago, because their house got infested by fleas just once. It seemed to be a thing in the Isle of Man that it just hit the perfect storm. It was the perfect seasonal weather, and all the farm animals in the vicinity, that lots of houses ended up with infestations of fleas. And it couldn't have worked out better because, as it happened, some less desirable relatives visited at that time that my mum and dad didn't really want, and they turned up unannounced, and they got flea bitten, and the beds were full of fleas, and they never ever came back again. So win. But that flea thing, I bought it and we stuck it in my gran's room. My gran was in her final years and she had a room in the house, and we stuck it in, not telling her it was a flea light. We told her it was a nightlight or something like that, and she was delighted. As a nightlight, we just stuck it under a sofa and it glowed at night, and she actually really liked it. Here's a circuit board. Let's get the other screws out. I shall keep them separate. I think they're all the same screws though. I wonder, looking at this, I see lots of resistors. Is it resistor per LED? Could be resistor per LED. Why that standby current? I am intrigued by that standby current. Not much in the back, just to see. It is really just a switch in the back, little standard tactile switch, and then the circuitry in the front. Okay. Right, I shall take a picture of this and we can explore it. One moment, please. Reverse engineering is complete. Let's explore quite an unusual circuit. I shall zoom in just a little bit. We have a 8-pin microcontroller, very common, with its little decoupling capacitor next to it. The USB connector, the USB-C connector, powers that directly, and it has two 5.1K resistors going to the identification pins so that it knows it is connected to a load and will actually apply power. It's also worth mentioning the bit that was drawing that rogue 75-ish milliamps is this 68 ohm resistor. I initially thought that might just be part of the filtering circuit for the microcontroller, but that is just a load resistor and it's slapped directly across 5 volts. And that means that it gets up to about 25 degrees Celsius above ambient temperature. It could be to keep power banks awake, or it could be to give a very slight heat signature to this, like the old ones used to have a 15-watt bulb in them, or maybe it was 5-watt, I'm not really sure. But it provided light and heat, so I'm not sure, that could be double purpose there. But either way, it does draw pretty much what, you know, when you have it at full white or full ultraviolet, this resistor here is drawing about as much current, so that's not going to be great for power bank life. There are four transistors. The four transistors each have a 10K base resistor, and they're standard NPN transistors. And the reason they've got four is because one is switching, say, these three white LEDs, and the other is switching these two white LEDs. And then the same, we've got three ultraviolet LEDs connected to one and two ultraviolet LEDs connected to the other. Lots of resistors. The reason for that is because every single LED is its own resistor, which is good. And those resistors are all connected to the positive power rail. And we've got 150 ohm resistors for the ultraviolet LEDs and 180 ohm resistors for the white LEDs. And basically speaking, the positives are all common in resistors. They go to LEDs, and then the LED negatives are common in those clusters and over to those resistors. There is another 10K resistor here, which is a pull-up resistor for the switch, which is on the other side here. And when you press the switch, it just pulls the end of that down to the 0-volt rail and signals to the microcontroller the switch has been pressed. That is it. It's a very straightforward circuit. Let's bring in the schematic. I've abbreviated the schematic because there are so many resistors and transistors on it. So there's just one in the schematic. But that's all we need to identify the appropriate circuit components. So here's the USB-C connector. Here is plus 5 volts, plus 5 volts approximately. Here is 0 volts. We have the two control resistors for the USB-C port, two 5.1K resistors going to the 0-volt rail. We have that load resistor, 68 ohms, just slapped across the 5 volts. We have a decoupling capacitor. We have the 10K pull-up resistor for the switch. So when you press the switch, it pulls this to the 0-volt rail, and the microcontroller sees a decisive transition from positive to the negative, effectively, from the 5 volts to the 0 volts. Then every transistor, all four of them, has a 10K resistor to its base, and then it's got a cluster of transistors. So for instance, the one that's got the two LEDs connected to it will have the two LEDs connected like this, and likewise for the three LEDs. The whites are in a set of 3 and 2 with 180 ohm resistors passing 10 milliamps each. The ultraviolet are connected in a set of 3 and 2, and they have a 150 ohm resistor passing 11 milliamps. So they're roughly aiming at 10 milliamps per LED. And that is it. Oh, let's write what this transistor is. It is a J3Y times 4. So a very straightforward circuit. Now, the question is, should I actually put this under my bed tonight and see if anything crawls off the floor into it? I hope not. I don't think I've got bugs in the bedroom, but you know, the temptation is to just stick it under the bed, plug it into your USB power supply and see what happens. Well, hopefully not burst into flames in the middle of the night. So if the video ends here, you know that nothing was found, or I'll leave a comment down the description. Or if there's anything worth showing, I'll actually just continue the video on. But if it ends here, there was nothing interesting to show. If the video continues after this point, then there was something on the floor. Hopefully not. But there we have it, a very straightforward little device. Just a bug attractor that is basically a low-level light that sits on the ground and is specifically designed to attract insects along the ground. And then they get stuck on the sticky mat. And that is it. Interesting little device. And now for the trial.